In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to create pie charts or graphics like this that you need for your report or your project. So I did this everything in CorelDraw, and I did it quickly because I understand about rotation and then the transform tool and how to make copies out of objects. Okay. So the very first thing, so for example here, these are equally divided into 4, and then this one 3, and then this one is 12. We also have to remember that the circle is 360 degrees. So for example here, 360 degrees, so divided by 4, so that would be 90 degrees for each pie here. Okay, so for example here, it's 3 parts of the 360, so that would be 120 degrees for this, and this one is 12 parts of 360, so 360 divided by 12, that would be 30. Okay, so now I'm gonna put it down there, and then so what we're gonna do here first is we have to create a circle. So first let's create a circle. And everybody knows how to create the circle. It's just click on the circle tool. Hold down your control key in your keyboard. Hold it down, and then make a perfect circle. Yeah. So now, before anything else, I have to show you, and you have to understand about the rotation pin. I call that rotation pin, but I don't know what's really the name of it. But I'll just call it rotation pin. So what is rotation pin? So for example, I'm going to make a straight line. So I'm going to click on my Bezier tool and click on, let's say here, click here. And then if I want to go make a straight line going up, I hold down my shift and control key in my keyboard. Just hold it down and click. So that would be a perfect straight line going up. Okay. Now I'm going to zoom in here, or yeah. So if you want to rotate an object, right, so you click on the first time and then click one more time, and then you can see these handles. So these handles are the rotation angles, are rotating angles. So if I click on, just hold it and then click and then rotate. So that will be my rotation angle. Okay. So now I'm going to hit undo until I go to the straight line. And you notice when I'm doing this, right? When I'm doing this, the center is here. The center of the rotation is here in the middle, right? But how do you change the rotation pin? So click one more time, and then this circle here, you click and then drag it to, say, the edge here, to that node. And then if I move rotate now, it's going to be a different rotation, right? That is a very, very useful thing, especially when you're dividing a circle into, say, 4 parts, 3 parts, or whatever part you want. Okay, so now I'm going to delete that. Now here, this is the circle. So what I'm going to do here is I have to make sure that my snap to guidelines is turned on, and also the objects. Actually, I forgot to mention that when you're creating the line, okay, and you're creating the line like that, and then remember when I click like that and then it snaps, make sure before doing anything else, you have to click on view and then go to snap to, and then make sure it snaps to objects. I also want to ask you to click on make this check for the guidelines too. So both objects and guidelines, and I'll show you why guidelines is important. And now also you have to make sure that guidelines is turned on here. Okay. So for here, first I want to find the center, okay, center of the circle. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to drag here my guidelines. So you just click and then drag until you see that quadrant, until you see the center. So when you see the center, you just release it. Okay. And then you got that one, and then you also get this edge and then center. Okay, so now in the intersection of these two guidelines is this one here, which is the center of the circle. Okay. Okay. So now I'm going to grab my line here. The only problem here in CorelDraw, I don't know if this is intentionally done. Remember, I already fixed the rotation pin here earlier, but when I click one more time again, it went back to the center here. So always make sure that say for example there, always make sure that you check that rotation goes back here. Okay. So now for example here, I want to put this one here to the center here. So when I click on that, grab the edge and then move it to the center until it snaps to the center. That one. And then again, double click on the rotation, click one more time, and then yeah, it's here, it's not in the center. So that's good. So now the command that we are looking for here, or the feature, is go to objects, transformation, and click on rotate. So for your rotate, you're going to see this dialog box here. Normally it's 0 here and 0 there. Okay, because that was earlier when I was using this. So this is empty, and I don't know why it doesn't go out, but anyway. So click on this, and then let's say, for example, I want 4 equal parts, so that's 360 divided 4, that's 90. So I type in 90 here, okay? And then let's go back here. I'm just gonna check the rotation angle. Okay, that's good, it's already there. And then make sure to put the copies, like, so how many copies? So I'm just gonna imagine, so this is already one copy. You got one copy here, two, and then three. So I need 3 more copies to complete the circle. So I type in 3 here, and then I click apply. Okay, so when I click apply, because we put 90 degrees here and the center, and then copies 3, that's why it's here. Okay. Now we got 4 equal parts here. So the next thing you have to do is your smart fill tool. So you click on smart fill, and then specify what color. So let's say orange, I want orange. And then the next one would be say pink. And then the next one would be that color and that color. And then now you just have to delete the lines that you created. And you can also delete the guidelines. Okay, I'm gonna delete the guidelines and this guideline. Okay, so 1/4. Now let's say 1/3. Okay, 1/3. So I'm just going to do this quickly since we already know how to do it with the first one. So I'm just gonna go quick. So circle, we go circle. I'm gonna create a line from here going up. Hold down shift, and then to change the rotation angle, click one more time. And then grab this, put in the end, okay? And then now I will go get my guidelines, make sure I'm in the center, find the center, that's the center, and this one, edge, you have to wait for the text to show center, so that's my center, so I'm going to grab this one, and then I am going to grab this one, make sure you're grabbing the node, and put it to the center. Okay, center. Okay, so while that is selected, we'll go back here. So if I want 3 equal parts, so that's 360 divided by 3 is 120. So I'm gonna make this 120 degrees, and then make sure here you click on the center here, because that's where we wanna rotate. And then, so how many copies now? So we're not talking about 3 copies here. We're only talking about 2 copies. Alright? 2 copies, and then click apply. Okay. See, this is, I don't know if this is a bug in Corel, but I already selected the center here. of the rotation, so you have to be careful. So I'm gonna make sure that I click one more time. See, the center is here. I'm just gonna put this back. Very important, if that happens to you, make sure to go back and then make sure the center is here and click here, which is the center of the rotation, and then apply. Okay, still doing that. I think, see, it goes back here again. I click this. Okay, so click here. I don't know why it's going. Okay, so maybe here's what I'm gonna do. I click one more time and grab this going down here. And then I think if I choose this one, lower left corner, which is that is my lower left, maybe this will work. Yes. So you have to choose this one at the center. Okay, let's go back here. And then now you go to, now you can, here, there, that's it. So it looks like smart tool, and then I'm going to delete this, delete that, and delete that one. Okay, so for the last one, we're going to do the 12 parts. Okay, I'm just gonna do this quick. Delete this one, delete that. Okay, so we're going to do, I'm gonna create a straight line first. Click here, hold on Control Shift, going up, and then I'm going to put the center first. Find the center, that's the center, good. And then here, find the center, that's it. And then this one, click one more time and then bring this down to the bottom, and then click here and then hold the node and then make it to the center like that. Okay, then I think we'll just leave it to lower left corner here. So if we're gonna do 12 parts, we're just gonna do this 30, because 360 divided by 1 divided 12 is 30. And then we go how many copies? So we go 11 copies, because it's minus 1, right? It's 12. And then click on apply. Okay, now you go to your smart fill tool and then you just change the color. What I'll do, I'll just alternate it like that. And then orange, I'm just doing it quickly here because we already know the concept, right? And then I'm just going to delete all of this. So that's it. The tutorial is done. And as long as you know the concept of it, and then you can review my tutorial. I know the rotation here, you have to choose the lower left corner. So, but anyway, that's already fixed. And that's it. And thank you very much.